Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. In this video, I'm going to introduce a 4-digit 7-segment display based on HT16K33, based on this chip, that can do everything that you expect from it, using only 4 wires, which uses I2C communication. You can easily display integer if you want preceding zeros, or if you want to display negative integer, or display float with multiple digits, float with negative, blank, or use it as a clock, as you can see with a counter and negative, or positive, or display hexadecimal values, increase or decrease the brightness, or use it as a UV meter or level of sound or something that you want to display or decrease, or a stereo UV in both direction, or even use it as a raw display that you can turn on any element in any way you want. You can use multiple of these displays with Arduino. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. And this is the display. When you purchase it, they will ship it like that. There is a protective sheet on it, so you have to remove it. We have only 4 wires here. This is not soldered. Once it arrives, you have to solder it. This is a main chip. The chip is HT16K33. For Arduino, there are so many options to display, but this display was the best one that I finally found, where we can display floating point, where we can display an integer, we can use it as a clock, we can even use it with a negative value. So this is the best ever you can get, because it can use this I2C communication, only 4 wires, and it can be used for everything that you need. The brightness can be set. I will create a lot of videos to use this with temperature sensor, voltmeter, potentiometer, with anything that I have. With it needs 4 digits, I'm using it. And also I'm going to demonstrate it with using a clock, because it has a column and it can easily be used for many other purposes. The product have been introduced by Adafruit, and they're selling it. I will provide you the link that you can get it from Amazon or from AliExpress. I bought it from this store, from AliExpress, for $2.30 Canadian. It's around $2 US, with some shipping that you can wait. And also, and if we search AliExpress, there are different variations of this available, but this display is available widely. This can be viewed from further distances because of the brightness of the screen and the size. And from the code, you can set the brightness at any level between 0 to 15. I believe 15 levels of brightness you can set it. Because this uses I2C communication, so these 2 pins can be shared on the same bus, and each will have different address, which you can set on the code, which I'm going to show you for 2 of this, and you can apply the same method for multiple of these. The chip is made by Haltech. You can get more information from this website. I will provide you the data sheet. The chip is offered in 20-pin package, 24-pin and 28-pin. And on this module, we have this 28-pin package, 28 SOPA. Operating voltage is 4.5 to 5.5. That's why we are using it with 5 volts. I2C bus interface. This is the model of the display, but we should not be worried about it, because library is taking care of everything. This is 0.56 inch in terms of length of the digits. And as you can see, we have column and we have decimal points. From the library and from the code, you can turn the column on and make this a clock, so we will send hour and minute. And if you want to display decimal point, some voltage with floating number, these decimal points, any of these can be turned on and off at any moment that you want. Let me explain now the wiring. We have from 5 volts ground, A4, A5. As you can see, this 5 volts is green. Green is connected on the left pin. ground is blue, connected to the second one. And then A4, this purple, is connected to the third one. And the last one is connected in here. So they have been connected accordingly, and you will not make mistake. Now let me explain the code. I've downloaded the library from this URL. Author is Rob Taylart, and this is the link. When we visit it, we can download the library and get it. And if you click on Tools, Manage Libraries, wait for this to complete. And here type HT16K33. You will see all these library. The first one is Rob Taylart. I've installed it. This is installed for you. It will be just install. Click and install it. And that the installation is complete. Once you install the library, you can access the examples by clicking at File, Examples. Scroll down until you will see somewhere on the list HT16K33, and these are all the examples that are available. If I click on GitHub, these are the examples that is available in your Arduino UNO menu. Demo 1, VU, cache, display integer, display raw, display time, dual display, and test print float. And here you can set display on or display off to turn it on and off. You can set the brightness between 0 to 15. So 0 is dim, 15 is, you just put the number here. And if you want to blink, the number of blinks, so 0 to 3, how fast it blinks. And here, some data types. You can display integer, you can display hexadecimal. And when you display dates, you will send two portions. For example, the month and the day. You just put comma. And like that, month, day or hour as a separator. And also, if you want to display time, you have to send minute and hour. And then for colon, we have to turn it off separately. For float, you just put from -999, because it's 4 digits, up to 9999, and there is no overflow indication. If you want to use it a level meter for something, you can send, you can display VU left or VU right. And now let me explain the code that I'm demonstrating, because there are multiple examples. I put them all together for the main features that we want. First, this line includes a library, which I've just explained to you. From this library class, we create this object called segment, and we pass the I2C address. And these are the value that is used inside the code. Inside the setup, we initialize a serial monitor with 115,200. If you go and click on Tools, Serial Monitor, you will see the Serial Monitor, or press Shift, Control Shift M, or press this. And then here on the right side, you will see this number must match, otherwise you will not be able to see this text. This line initializes with seg.begin. This line initializes the 7-segment display. This line initializes the I2C communication using the wire class. And this turns on the display segment dot display on. And then we set number of digits that you want. This is just displaying a text on the serial monitor. And then this display test is testing all the digits on this. When I turn it on, let's see, I'm restarting it. That test is this line. And then we turn off the display. After that, keep it for 1 second off. You see, after this, it goes off and then on. So this line is taking care of that. And then it turns the colon false. After that, we say one digit and display 64 for 5 seconds. And this line displays with 4 digits, that's 64. This line displays 74 with negative. As you can see, this line displays 33, now 0.4 5 with one decimal place, and next it will be displayed with 3 decimal places. After that we have 1 decimal place and then 1 decimal place with this. Turn it off, turn it on. We set the display with 2 digit, and this line is displaying clock 18 and 25. After that, this is just a counter that adds the number from minus 300 to 300, and then after that we have this value of hex, and then this loop is continuously printing the hex value with just added value, and also increase and decrease the brightness. And here is a code how to read the potentiometer. So we define this object. As I mentioned before, we read the analog zero pin. The value is stored here in a sensor value, and then we get the same sensor value multiplied by 5 volts divided by 1023. And the calculation of this is a voltage. And here we say print voltage using display float with 1 decimal place. If you want 2 or 3 decimal places, just change that. And this 500 millisecond is the delay. If you want to display it faster, with faster refresh rate, reduce this number. For example, make it 50 or less or more. And here is a demonstration of reading potentiometer. 5 volts. I'm rotating it. The voltage is reduced and read very nicely. This is now with 3 decimal places, and here I changed it to 1 decimal place. Just adjusting it. And here is a demonstration of using 2 displays simultaneously. And here is the code for it. First, we define the display on the left side with the I2C address of 71. And the next one, we call it right. And 0x70, that's the hex value of 70. So we define the address. We get the class and we define the display on the left side, which is this one, and we define the display on the right side. And for each we pass I2C address, and they must be different. And after that we just use left and right to refer and set them. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this HT16K33 4-digit 7-segment display. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates on my upcoming videos. This is based on 74HT595 shift register, and 2 digits have been arranged in the module, something like this. When you buy it, there will be no pins attached to it. Simple, there are 2 surface mount devices. All the LEDs have been arranged with the bias with the resistor, so you don't have to worry about the resistor. All the pins labeled here, and as you can see, you can cascade it also if you have other digits attached to this, but for now this two will be enough because we have four digits and